All right, McKenzie Mitch, let's go.
We've
got to find some NXT superstars to chat with.
We've got lots of questions here on a Thursday morning.
Who we got?
Jesse.
Thanks for
talking
to us.
Do you want to?
Yeah.
Jesse! Hi!
Hey!
That wasn't very nice.
I mean, they're never nice though. Remember when we had the Robert Stone brand on here? They were very rude.
That's right.
Very rude.
Didn't get cleared by Robert Stone. I understand though, we were interrupting her time at gym, so a very important time for her. But
whatever, Jesse Kamea. We did happen to talk to someone who was very nice to us.
Yes.
NXT Breakout Tournament superstar Carmelo Hayes.
Congratulations on your victory on Tuesday night over Josh Briggs. You're now advancing in the Breakout Tournament.
Yes.
What does this experience mean to you?
I feel like this experience is just, you know, it means who's the best of the new guys that are coming in. And, you know, I have a lot to prove, and I put out a tweet saying that I have a lot to prove, and I feel like this is my opportunity to do that in this tournament.
Is there anyone in particular that you have your eye on?
I mean, I have my eye on everybody. You know, I don't want to sleep on anybody in this tournament. Obviously, these guys are in this tournament for a reason because they are the best, you know, guys that are here now. But I think my eye right now currently is on Duke Hudson.
Duke Hudson.
Carmelo, one more question before we let you go. Goal of yours here in NXT?
All right, we're going to go with a short-term goal.
Okay. You
know, I'm going to win the NXT Breakout Tournament. That my short-term goal.
Okay.
And I'm calling my shot right now.
Put it there.
On Thursday morning with McKenzie and Alicia.
That's all right.
Thanks, Carmelo.
Oh, I like Carmelo. What a great guy. Every time I've gotten to interview him, he's just nothing but great.
Well, good luck to Carmelo Hayes. The NXT Breakout Tournament continues next Tuesday on Sci-Fi. We are on Sci-Fi for another week.
Super excited.
Next week, we're going to see Trey Baxter taking on Joe Gacy.
Ooh, I'm excited for that. I love the Breakout Tournament. So cool for all the upcoming NXT superstars.
Joe Gacy hit me in the neck and spilled my coffee on the floor a couple weeks ago.
Okay, did he apologize?
He did. It was an accident. I gotta say it was an accident. I like Joe Gacy. I'm excited to see them next week. He did apologize and he helped wipe up the coffee.
Okay, well, what a great guy. I have a question. I know you got here a little bit earlier than I did on Thursday morning. Did you happen to see Indy Hartwell?
I did, and I saw this t-shirt.
That's where
here.
I was going, because
what is this
I
about?
Told her I would bring her a t-shirt back from Dexter, Missouri, and I wore it.
Wait a minute. You told Indy Hartwell you're going to bring her a souvenir from your travels.
Yep.
And you're wearing it.
I've got the t-shirt on. It'll be fine. I'll just wash it and then package it up in like a gift or something.
Nice.
And give
did
it
you get me anything from Missouri?
Did you get me anything from Rolling Loud?
Oh!
Right? You were in Miami. How was that, Alicia?
Oh, McKenzie Mitch, that was lit. I'm going to say lit because I'm still on the hip-hop vibe.
Oh, good for you.
From the weekend. I was at SmackDown live from the largest hip-hop festival in the world.
Do you like hip-hop music?
I do. My favorite is Lil' Kim.
Okay.
I like Cardi B. I like Wale. I got to introduce hip-hop icon Wale to the stage on Friday night. It was amazing.
Wow, what an experience. But what about Tuesday night? It was also an experience. We had a lot of fun on Sci-Fi. Bronson Reed, Adam Cole.
Wow, those two men tore each other apart. But our friend, our fellow What's Nexter Bronson Reed, he's on a bit of a losing streak these days.
I know, poor Bronson. But two former NXT North American champions going head-to-head. Adam Cole said he's out to prove that he's the best in NXT, and Bronson Reed laid out the challenge for them. But what about Kyle O'Reilly? I mean, this is, I feel like, the saga that never ends between these two, but in a good way. There's still unfinished business that we are getting to watch.
I mean, Kyle O'Reilly, Adam Cole have such a long history.
Yeah.
We are going to continue to see this because, when Undisputed Era broke up, that left a lot of, it's like, it's brothers.
Yeah,
you know?
It is. It's personal. But on the note of personal, Raquel Gonzalez, Dakota Kai. We knew that this was going to come. This is how friends work. This is how the stories go.
Is this how friends work?
I mean, one friend in
somebody
wrestling it is.
Do your friends kick you in the face on a regular basis?
Well, no, but I'm saying in wrestling it is. I feel like Dakota Kai, Raquel Gonzalez, everything was great, hunky-dory, and then one friend gets greedy.
This,
and that's what happened.
This was the kick heard around the world, but you know what? This is my favorite Dakota Kai, I have to say.
What? Your favorite Dakota Kai?
This is my favorite Dakota Kai. This is reminiscent of 2019 War Games when she crushed little Tegan.
Who are you? This is so rude of you to say. I mean, you're always aggressive, but like you like a mean Dakota Kai.
I do. I do.
Okay. Well, I could kind of tell when I was interviewing them not too long ago that there was some tension that was building because I saw a small little look from Dakota to Raquel. And then I was like, I don't think I should intervene in this.
You didn't tell Raquel.
Why would I tell Raquel? Wasn't the time, wasn't the place.
You're trying to mend your relationship with Raquel. Remember when she was going to destroy you and our set?
Yes, she did destroy our set. Not me, thankfully. We've made up since. But, I mean, it was not my time or place to get in and say, hey, is everything okay between you two? It wasn't like an episode of, like, Mari or something.
Would you tell me if someone was going to attack me?
Of course I would, because you're my tag team partner.
Put her there. Park the car.
Okay, anyways. Tuesday night.
Tuesday
Samoa night. Joe is back to being an in-ring competitor.
McKenzie, Mitch, I think the entire NXT universe has been waiting for this moment. We don't want to see Joe on security detail.
We sure don't.
We want to see Joe crushing people in the ring.
I mean, but do you think that Karrion Kross has barked up the wrong tree?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Could we possibly see a third title run in NXT for Samoa Joe?
Personally, I would love that. But can you imagine who would want to provoke or to then, if he were to become the NXT champion, to go up to Samoa Joe and say, hey, I want to fight you?
You.
What? No, never. I absolutely would not. Carmelo Hayes would probably.
Oh, Carmelo Hayes. He would probably get crushed.
Yeah, okay, well, maybe that was a bad idea. Anyways.
Either way, we're getting Samoa Joe versus the NXT champion Karrion Kross at NXT TakeOver 36.
I'm so excited for that. But what I'm also very looking forward to is next week. Love her or lose her match. Oh, Indy Hartwell's love life is on the line. But Johnny Gargano, Dexter Lumis, I mean, at one side, she's got her family pulling her, and on the other side, her heart is pulling her. I'm imagining she's so stressed out right now.
I mean, if Johnny Gargano wins, Dexter and Indy are not allowed to date.
That's not very fair, do you think?
That's not fair at all, Mackenzie Mitch.
So we're pulling for Dexter Lumis and Indy Hartwell. Can their love be strong enough?
Love will prevail.
Always does. So I got you this.
I bought this.
No, you didn't.
I literally bought this.
Fine, then give it back.
Guys, tune in on Tuesday. Do not miss NXT action on Sci-Fi. On Sci-Fi for one more week. Mackenzie Mitch.
What's next?